What is architecture for you?
Well, as I said, what is architecture is a metaphysical question that I really don't know how to answer, but I can explain maybe one aspect that is really important for me in architecture. I think that architecture is a common knowledge, is a shared knowledge. So we have to work a lot trying to reinforce this idea of a knowledge that we can all contribute in. So it's a collective thing. It's always the result of a very complex process. And it's a knowledge that can be transmittable and shareable through all the architecture that have been built or designed through time, so that can be studied and understood and communicated. I don't really believe in the, let's say, contemporary idea of architecture as a product of a genius, of an authorial product per se, but I think that this is an invention that really changed the meaning and the importance of architecture into something else that, in my opinion, is not really productive. I don't know how long should it be. Personally, I always try to work on this idea with my office, with Salottobuono, my office that did an extensive work of research and attempt in communicating all the built architectures to the public, through magazines and so on. And with the magazine I'm part of the board of, which is San Rocco magazine, we presented the last Biennale a contribution on collaboration. It was called Collaboration, and it was the basis of an issue that we published. And in this project, we tried to explore two modes of collaboration among architects, collaboration that can develop through time and the collaboration that can happen simultaneously, you know, between two architects living in the same moment, in the same time. Somehow, collaboration in the present are based on larger idea of collaboration with the past, with architects of the past. So we really believe into this historical perspective that is not only historical, but it's projective. And I think this is at the same time, well, it's also an important aspect of the project I'm developing with the US Pavilion this year, that is also based on an archive of projects and will speculate on the future, so it will make this repository of knowledge productive.
And so this architecture's knowledge, what can it do? What can it bring?
What can it bring? In very general terms, I think it can bring an improvement of the condition of life of everybody in the world. Architecture is not an innocent tool, is never innocent, I would say. It always hides or reveals specific goals, and so in the best cases, an architectural object is not only an object, but it's a device, it's an apparatus that works in close relations with social, political, economical dynamics in order to constitute the node of this network that that becomes productive and that becomes strategic into this network.
Okay. And how do you position yourself with your architecture in the discourse?
Well, my position tries always to be ethical. I'm trying to understand what is the meaning of my work and what can be the effect. Sometimes the effect of the work of architects can be terrifying, I'm just trying to be conscious of that and contribute to the progress of our daily life through my work in a very maybe humble, modest way, without the necessity of being, let's say, of doing extraordinary works in terms of visibility and so on. We have to be realistic, we have to go with the market, of course, but at the same time we can oppose sometimes a bit of resistance to the market and produce something more meaningful.
And with San Rocco you've taken a very strong position, I think, in the architecture publishing. Would you like to say a few words about that?
Yes, the position we have taken is a position of responsibility, I guess. We tried to imagine a project that could be not only about communication of architecture. We don't really believe in the communication of architecture. Architecture explains itself somehow, but when we started the work of San Rocco, we felt a particular lack of ideas in general in the architectural publishing, in the Italian architectural publishing scenario in particular. So we wanted to contribute to with a platform of thinking that could be not tied to fashion, not to the fashion of the moment, that could have a time of development that is relatively slow. So in order to work on the ideas, to produce essays with a certain with the possibility of thinking about them, we again wanted to establish a collaborative project that involved a large network of architects, and we wanted to communicate with other realities, publishing realities around the world that for us, in our opinion, were particularly interesting. And basically we wanted to have a platform of thinking and discussion, and we wanted to talk about architecture in a sort of competent way, without escaping the subject, no, as many other publishers tried to do. So with a proper language, with a fitting language, and with drawings, with texts that are curated and edited, so on. And well, I think it's still a process, it's ongoing, but it's giving some results, in the sense that we have noticed that discourse is raising and it's producing some fruits. I mean.
My compliments about that. And last question, so what is your design method? Do you have a design method?
No. No, I don't have a design method. I have some design criteria and some design, I don't know, some goals. The method, I think, is adapting to every specific condition. I would say that a constant of my work is that I'm trying to understand the context and understand the past. Yeah.